discussion for central and center of gravity in this chapter will involve four main type of component, okay? Which is the first one, we go to the central and center of gravity of line, this one of the line, and then the second part is central or center of gravity of common component and or composite component for area. Okay, areas, which is area, there are two type of area. The first one is we will put in two dimension. Second one is in three dimension, and then the last one is for volume. Okay, which is in three dimension. Okay, so areas and volume in three dimension. Okay, so the line, of course, it is, this one is in 2D. Okay, so the line, maybe we have 1, 2, 3 component, and then we need to find the central and center of gravity of this composite line. In 2D, maybe we have this kind of component. Okay, with a hole here or something. You need to find the centroid for this component and the last one, which is in three dimension. So of course we go to the, how is it, in three dimension. Okay, so we need to find that one. In areas also, you can go to three dimension where we have a thin surface, thin plate. Okay, thin plate. This way we become the 2D, but the thin plate we put in 3D. Maybe there is some shape, something, but it is a thin plate. So we go to the areas, but in three dimension. We will discuss one by one later on. But the first one, let's go to this one. Central and center of gravity of common composite line. Okay, so maybe something wrong. Common and composite line. So we go to the first one, which is in two dimension. So remember what I said, we have, when we talk about centroid, okay, we actually want to put the centroid in term of coordinate from 0, 0. So we put it x bar and y bar, the location of x bar and y bar in term of coordinate. Okay, and the small x and y is referred to each and every component, the big one is referred to the whole component. So the equation will be this one. So we have x bar equal to sigma small x bar delta w divided by sigma delta w, and the y bar is equal to sigma y bar delta w divided by sigma delta w, and this is the big x, big y, and small x, small y. Okay, and then we have the component in line. So line is this way, maybe with this is delta L, this is area A. Okay, the area of that component. So we have, this is a line, and then we have delta W. What is delta W? Delta W equal to rho gravity A times delta L. Okay, A times delta L. Okay, so since the, for we said, what is the homogeneous component? For homogeneous, meaning that the A is constant value. So divided delta W divided by delta W here. If we have A which is homogeneous, which is this one will be a constant value A, and then of course gravity is gravity, constant value, we divide, we can have one. Rho is the same component, so up and above we have the same component, also rho divided by one, so it will become at the end is delta. The one that is changed is now delta L. So our final equation will be x bar equal to sigma x bar delta L divided by sigma delta L, y bar equal to sigma y bar delta L divided by sigma delta L. Okay, So the L is the length of the component. So x bar is the position of in x and y direction for each and every component, and the x and big y is the, for the whole component. Okay, so we will use these two equations actually. Okay, we use these two equations to calculate the centroid for composite line x and y. Okay, this way, if the component is homogeneous, same row, so this is constant. But if we combine several components with different row, we have to put back row here. So we have another one here, which is row. So it depends. If there's same component, just attach together several part, so we only use this one. But if, let's say, we have iron attached with aluminium and so on, so of course we have that row which is different. Okay, so we put row here. So it depends on the question. But the main, the big equation start from here, letter W, and we know it is here, so it depends on the component. Like here we have same component, so I will erase everything, come only delta delta L. Okay, so we'll try to do this one example from here. So this equation and that one. So one example taken from here, I have one. Okay, so let's take this one. Okay, so this is one, this is set, and then we have one component from here. A O, this one, and then this. Okay, a half circle here. Okay, a half circle here. Okay, so I have O A, O B, and C, which is here, given the R. R 0.4 meter. Or as given, until here is 0.3. So we have here is 0.3. Here is 0.4. Okay, so determine the location of some centroid of this composite line. Okay, so you need. Question is, you need to determine the centroid for this composite line. Composite meaning that we have several components attached together. Okay? So, the first step that we need to do is, we need to identify basic component, basic and simple component, which we know exactly where is the location of the centroid of that component. Okay? Because for this whole component, we didn't know where is the center of the combination of this three, of this whole component. But if we put the component in a small part, we can know where is the location. So first one, we need to divide the component or into a small component that we know the location of center. For example, here we have, we can have the first component here, one straight line OA. Okay, so the component is equal to the first one OA. Second one, we have OB. Okay, OB. And where is other colors? One. And I have last one is this one. So plus OB plus BC. Okay, so this is just a simple straight line. So this one, the centroid of this OA must be here, right in the middle here. Okay, OB also right in the middle, and OC, based on this table, you will see that we have this one somewhere here. Okay, based on this table, you have the equation. Okay, this one, Y bar, and this one, the Y bar, and it is in the middle. Okay, So based on that table, we know that the centroid of this one is here. Okay, so which is this is in the middle here, and the length here is given, what is it? 2r over pi. Okay, so we can know the position of each and every simple component here. Okay, so we will use this one to calculate or to determine where is the location of the centroid for the whole component. For these three components combined together, we can know by using the calculation. Okay, so we'll apply the equation that I've wrote before. So what is the equation? Okay, so we want to have what this one, this write again this equation, big one. X bar equal to sigma x bar delta L for homogeneous component, sigma delta L, y bar equal to sigma y bar delta L divided by sigma delta 2 times delta delta L. Okay, so what we need now is actually the x bar for each component, y bar for each component, and also the length of each component. So I will put it in the table. Here we will put it in this simple table so that we don't miss anything. Okay, so how many we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 and 4. And we have the first one is the component x bar, y bar. So we want to have the first one. We want to put the length of the component, and then xy, y bar, and the last one is x bar delta L. So x bar delta L, y bar delta L. Okay. So we have three components, OA, OB, OA, OB, and also BC. This is the sigma of everything. Okay. So we want to find one by one the length of the first component, OL. What did I do? The length of this one, OA, which is OA delta L for OA, is this is 0.4, so you put 0.4. Okay, the x bar, which is position x from this point, so this will be 0. Y bar, it is here down, going down to this point, so 0.4, negative 0.2. Okay, OB, the length of OB, this is put it this way. This is 0.4, 0.3, so of course this one is 0.3, this is 0.4, so this one is 0.4. So 3, 4, this one is 5. 0.5, okay, so the x bar will be here, up until this point, this is x bar, and until this one is the y bar. Okay, it must be half from here, so 0.3, positive 0.5. 1.5, y bar is going up, which is here is 0.4, positive 0.2. Okay, so we have 1 bar, 0.15, 0.2. And then we go to BC. BC, you need to calculate this one, the delta L, which is delta L, the length of this one, we have 2 pi r, is it? 2 pi r. Okay, which is the whole circle, so we have half circle, so it become divided by 2, so up it become pi r. So put it pi r here, pi r, which is here. So what we get here is, I've calculated here, pi divided by r is 0.4, so you have 1.257. So the x bar is from this line to this one, so here. So So we have 0.3 plus 0.4, positive 0.7. The y bar, what we want only, this one. Okay, so we know that whole system here up to there is 0.4. So 0.4 minus here, 2r divided by pi. This is the y bar for this one. Okay, so you do it there, you will have as, what do I have here? Y bar, 0.145. Okay, 0.145. So now we have everything, the x bar, the y bar, and delta L for each and every component, and then you take the calculator, you will do one by one. Delta L time this one will be put here, delta L time y bar will be put here, and so on, we will continue. So I have calculated that one, you can have this one, because this one times zero, so this is zero, negative 0.08, 0.075, 0.1, 0.88, this one is 0.183. Okay, so you add up together here, you want to have what? Sigma x bar and sigma delta L. Sigma y bar, sigma delta L. So you want this one. You want that sigma y bar and sigma delta L. Sigma x bar delta L. Okay, so you want to have this one and this one, these three. So this one, sigma will become, put it in other colors, you have, put it here, 2.16, you have that one. And sigma here will be 0.955. This one here, 0.203. Okay, and then lastly, we put in the equation the big x bar equal to this one, sigma x bar delta L. So sigma x bar delta L, 0.955 divided by sigma delta L, which is this one, 2.16, so equal to something. Y bar equal to this one, sigma y bar delta L, so you put this one, 0.203. Divided by sigma delta L, this one, 2.16, so you have, I've calculated that one, and then your answer will be, here we have x bar, 0.443 something, 0.094, okay, 0.994, and if the question asks you to draw the point of this x bar and y bar, so of course you can do it. It is the x bar 0.44 from x, so 0.3 is here, 0.4 might be here, so the somewhere here is the x bar, and y bar is 0.09, meaning that we have here is 0.4, half, get close to 0.1, so it is here, somewhere here. So the point of C is that. Okay, if the question asks you to put the point on this location, you will base on this one, you put. If not, you can leave in this term, x bar equal to this one, y bar equal to this one. Okay, so again, we just, using this equation, the first step is to determine the simplest component that you can directly know where is the exact location for the centroid. Okay, so in this case, we can divide into three simple components. Then you know which is the location. And then you want to apply this equation. Okay, so put it in the table, the thing that you need. Okay, which is the length, x bar, and also y bar. And then you multiply everything. You put the sum of everything. And then you put it back in the equation. You get the answer. Okay, so this is the simplest one, which is for the line. Later on, we go to the areas and also volume.